The government shutdown, how long will it last and what's really behind us? Joining us this morning, East Bay Congressman Mark DeSaulnier. What is this all about?
It's about an unstable genius as President of the United States and a non-functioning Congress.
Okay, so we have a great combination of Donald Trump and a non-functioning Congress. Mm-hmm. What is the issue at loggerheads here? Is it the border? Is it the wall security? Is that what this is all about?
No. If we actually listen to the experts, we would not spend the money the way he would like us to. But it's a good optic for his political base. So we're stuck in this fight where he wants us to appropriate $5 billion for a wall that hasn't been studied, and we don't know what it would cost and if it would be effective. What we should do is ask the General County Office to do an analysis.
Well, what we should do is be back in Washington leadership meeting. Around the clock to try to resolve this issue. You have 800,000 federal employees,
yep.
and it's the holidays now, but in a couple of days, people are going to be going back to work. They're going to want their passports renewed. They're going to want their immigration, and they're not going to want to see closed sides.
And in addition, it's costing us billions of dollars.
So why can't they? Are both sides just so entrenched that they're willing to go for the optics over getting the government back?
No, this is what happens when we put our narcissistic imbecile in charge. I'm sorry, as the President of the United States.
That's a talking point, but the other
it's a reality.
Okay, it's a reality, but the other side would say, okay, you guys, this is what happens when you put a bunch of people on that don't want to have a border discussion, don't want to have security on the borders, and they're answering to their own bases.
No, that's not accurate, Phil. We have multiple bills that are bipartisan. Will Hurd, a Republican who represents the largest portion of the border from Texas, he has a bill with a Democrat, Pete Aguilar from California. If it went on the floor, it would vote. It would begin to solve all of these problems. So if you had a functioning federal government that wasn't driven by somebody who wants to drive the American people apart, we would have a compromise bill. And that bill exists today if it was on the floor for vote. It would pass.
The last time the bill went on the floor for the vote...
Never went on. This bill never has been on the floor.
But the last time that the Democrats were going to stop the bill from going forward, Nancy Pelosi said... the Republican idea, and she didn't. It passed, right?
Well, you're separating issues here. The bill that the Republican put on the floor and passed that Nancy said they didn't have the vote for, they turned out it did, was for the appropriations, and that had the border wall in that. Now, this is why it's more complicated than it appears. The wall is a nice symbol to the President of the United States, but the experts say that's not where they want us to spend the money. There's more effective ways. This is a over 2,000 stretch of land we're talking about, and it's not the most effective way to build a wall. Sounds good. The Chinese did it a long time ago.
How long do you see this going on?
Well, we'll get in charge next week. So when we get in charge, my expectation is we would pass the bill that the Senate already passed, that the president had agreed to, that has funding, reopens government, has funding for border security, but not for his stupid wall.
Okay, so you see it ending next week?
Well, what will happen is, I think, this bill will pass out with the Democrats in charge, go back to Mitch McConnell, and it will be the same bill that they passed out unanimously 2 weeks ago that the president had agreed to. Then he got up in the morning and heard his neoconservatives on TV saying he was a sellout, and then he flipped. So it's very hard to bargain. You watch politics. For all of our shortcomings, you have to have a certain amount of trust, and right now there is no trust because of the President of the United States.
And how long do you see this going on?
Hopefully it'll be done next week. I mean, that's my hope. But there has to be a reality check here. And that's what we have to come to. I would be willing to spend more money on border security if we had General County Office come in with the experts and say, this is how you spend it to make the border more secure.
Do you think it'll be done next week, or do you see this going on for 2 or 3 weeks?
With this president, who knows? But I hope it'll be done next week. A rational person in that office would come to a compromise with us. We're willing to compromise.
Okay. All right. We're going to can you stick around for a little bit? Because I'd like to talk also about the wall and the funding and border security, which is the hot topic. We're talking about the wall and the government shutdown over the wall and border security. Now, we have a product, we have policy, and then we have the wrapping around the policy. The question is border security, especially in light of what has happened in California in the shooting of the policeman this weekend and the subsequent arrest of three people, possibly illegal, here in the United States. What is the deal with the wall? Why are the Democrats so opposed to it?
Well, I would say the real deal is we have an immigration crisis. We need to have a discussion and a bipartisan discussion on immigration policy in this country, and the wall is part of that. So the reason we don't want to spend the money on the wall is we're told by experts it's an ineffective way to actually secure the border. So we need more staff down there. I've been there. We need more judges. We need more Border Patrol people to process these record numbers of asylum seekers.
Okay, so you want to process them and have them come into the United States?
No. They're allowed legally under a law from 1980 to seek asylum if they're under duress in their country of origin. Only 20% of the people who apply actually get that. So that system has been working, but it's stretched because we went from 5,000 people seeking asylum 10 years ago to now almost 100,000 people because of what's happening in Central America. That's a functional problem that we should address and fix.
Okay, when we're talking about addressing and fixing. Let's stay on the border and right. The border security. How much are Democrats willing to spend on border security? He wants $5 billion, and that's going to the wall. How much are Democrats willing to spend?
Well, in our package, in the package that the Senate passed unanimously with an agreement with the president 2 weeks ago, is $1.6 billion.
Why not more? If it's such a pressing need, is $1.6 billion enough, or do we really need more?
We want to know where it's going. We want the experts to tell us how to spend
it. Who are the experts?
The General Accounting Office. They've already done a limited survey.
So
they want to do.
They should say do another. We should be spending on.
It's undetermined. This is like spending money. I know you think we spend money with blank check all the time, but we don't know how much a wall would cost. We don't know what we know.
Well,
it wouldn't be effective.
Let's move away from the wall and go to border security.
First, we were going to move.
No, because one guy calls it the wall, right. And that's his idea of border security. And then we have the Democrats saying we need more border security. The question is, what is your counteroffer to the wall?
$1.6 billion, and it's spent the way the professionals want to. So some of it would be more of a wall, making sure those parts that are not secure. Some of it would go into technology like drones, because these wide open spaces, they say that's more effective, more border patrolmen, and more people to adjudicate the people who are coming to the border that are creating a lot of the stress.
And you think that's enough?
I don't know if it's enough. That's why we want the General Accounting Office, the experts, to tell us. What he wants to do is build a wall. He doesn't know how much it would cost. He doesn't know whether it would be effective or not. And the experts are saying they would like us to spend the money in other ways than a wall all the way across Texas. So these are very remote areas. Very few people actually go across this illegally.
Right. But here's what it boils down to, Congressman. Is it a question the public has is, how much do we spend on defense a day?
Oh, it's ridiculous.
It's ridiculous. It's well over $1 billion.
Oh, absolutely.
Okay, so you're talking about less than 2 days of national defense on one of our most open and questionable areas. And people are arguing over it, and I want to know how much of this is about politics and how much of this is about trying to strengthen
it. Completely about politics. It's about this president thinking he just needs his base to get reelected, and they respond to the simple notion that if you build a wall, all the problems will go away. But it won't. And it's not an effective way to do it. So for myself, in good conscience, at this point in my life, am I going to vote for something that I know the experts are saying is not going to do what he says it will do? It won't help. But we can do things, and this is where the system is broken down. We have an immigration problem. It needs to be fixed, and it should be fixed with all of us working together like grown-ups, including the President of the United States.
Well, the day that happens, give us a call. We'll have breaking news.
We'll need a new president.
Congressman Mark DeSaulnier.